Up in Washington, by law, you're supposed to have pinched barbs on all your hooks. So make sure that you trim your barb off or clip it, whatever is easiest. So once that's firmly clipped down, what we're doing on the twitch and jigs too, is we're just tipping it with a little extra sand shrimp, piece of sand shrimp tail. Just fold it and put it through the hook like that, easy. Just adds a little scent and also some water soluble. I like sardine for spring chinook, works really well. Just squirt some of that on there. Ready to go. Good thing it doesn't mat up the feathers, so.
Anchor, yes, no?
That worked here.
I got a chinook on here. One of the Spro twitching jigs. Perfect. Everybody's heard of twitch and coho, but we thought we'd come in now that everybody's ran a bunch of bait through here and try twitch and jigs for springers, and look what happened. This hole's been beat to death today by numerous boats, guys egg fishing, and we figured that rather than come in here and try to play cleanup with gaba eggs like everybody else has done, we just figured we'd come through at the Spro Rockstars and run these through each of these holes, twitching, and we capitalized on it. We did bring some sand shrimp to tip jigs with, but on that particular one, I didn't have any bait tipped on it. It was just the jig with some water-soluble procure. Seemed to work. For twitching for chinook like we're doing here today, I generally what I'll run is the Cousins Tributary series. It's the GTS 79M, and it's a one-piece. And it's you want a shorter rod just because it's a little easier on your wrist working it all day. And this one here has an 8 to 17 pound line rating. So it's got a nice fast tip on it. And it's got a fair amount of backbone, which works really well for this technique. And as far as the reel goes, this is a Daiwa Fuego. For the money, they're a great reel. Got a good solid drag on them and just a good reel.
So the nice thing that Spro is doing here is they're offering these Rockstar jigs in a 3/4 ounce, both half and 3/4, which is a little heavier than what most companies are offering. The reason for that is things like this, you know, we're out here in the springtime twitching jigs, and really the 3/4 ounce performs a lot better in the higher flows. And on the bigger rivers, it started out a couple years ago, everybody was running the 3/8 ounce jigs, and now you barely see anybody running those even in the fall. So 1/2 ounce and 3/4, I think, is the way that everybody's going to be heading.